Case in point, David McCallum.
First one was when I was the youngest. My grandpa pulled me out of a river. I was floating face down. They didn't know where I was for a few minutes, and finally somebody seen me, and my grandpa jumped in and grabbed me and brought me back, I guess. That was the first time. And then after that, in school, I fell off the bleachers, landed on my head. And I've had quite a few car accidents and stuff like that.
In 1992, David, his wife Kathy, and their two children took an outing to the Genesee County Expo. They spent the day there, going on rides and visiting the petting zoo. But only one attraction preoccupied David: bungee jumping.
You hear a lot of people talking, I'd never do it, I'd never do it. You know, you're standing there and you're watching just the surrounding people. You know, it's like, well, these people don't have any guts, these people do. And, you know, there's young girls doing it. And I thought, well, I'm gonna do it. You know, I show them I'm there. And I showed them.
Our anniversary was coming up, and I thought, oh gosh, you know, I thought, well, if this is what you want, then that is going to be your gift. I'm not gonna buy anything else.
Okay, we're live. He's almost at the top. Dave's gonna jump.
You have so much adrenaline as you're going up in this cage. And matter of fact, I told the guy, he says, you might have to push me. And he said, well, it wouldn't be the first time.
Any last words?
I could just tell by the looks in his face that he was, you know, very nervous. And the kids were shouting, Daddy, Daddy. And I just know he was really excited. My heart was just pounding, and I just knew his was pounding.
What they tell you to do is you put your toes on the edge of the cage and put your hands up. And when he says 3, 2, 1 bungee, you go ahead and you just fall forward.
I just was watching him. Next thing you know, he was gone and the string was just hanging there.
My lower half hit the bag. My legs kind of come back behind me, and I speared the bag is what I did, and I guess I speared the ground with my legs, and the one shattered, and I never looked down to see it, but for what I'm told is my leg looked like an S, the shape of it. My foot was twisted around, and bones were sticking out.
I just screamed. I ran around into the gate, ran in there, and as I got closer to him, he shouted, get Kathy away from here, get her back. So I knew something was wrong. But I really thought he was dead at the time. I thought we weren't going to find him alive.
When I was laying there for a second, I thought, you know, I'm not dead. I'm not dead. I was thinking this to myself. But then when we got in the ambulance on the way to the hospital, that's when the pain started, and I was trying to play it off to where I was cool, you know, and just play it off. And I told the paramedic, I says, well, you know the saying where your mom tells you to always put clean underwear on in case you have an accident, and that's luckily I put clean underwear on. I shattered my ankle, shattered my leg. They put a plate, 7 pins back in it. Then after the accident, I was off work for a year and a half. The bills were adding up, and no money and no insurance, and it put a burden on the marriage.
It did put a lot of stress on the whole relationship, and the children were really, you know, frightened by what had happened. They didn't understand a lot of it, so it was hard on us.
David and Kathy were divorced a year after the accident. Now David is not able to see his children as often as he used to, but this has not kept his son from following in his father's footsteps.
My son Corey, he's riding a motorcycle by himself now. He rides a snowmobile, and hopefully for Christmas, I think he's gonna get a goat cart, but he's already had his first set of stitches in his forehead, and I think he's gonna have a few more